Hello, I'm really glad you joined me today to do the conditioning class. Today we're going to be focusing on triceps, top back of arm, and our core and our abs. Abs are going to include the erectus abs, also the oblique abs as well, and obviously the core to keep us in check. Okay, so what we'll be using today is we will be using a chair. I'm going to do some tricep dips on them. You can do it on the floor, you can do it as a tricep kick back. So no worries there. And I'm going to be using a medium heavy, and a heavy set of weights. So I'm going 3, 4, and 5 kilograms on those weights. Okay, so enough room to move about it. And then because every round will have two different exercises in each round, you'll be doing them 4 times each. And at the end of that round, I'll tell you, we'll be doing an aerobic section. The aerobic section is going to be just fast movements. Doesn't have to be high impact. Okay, so water bottle as well if you've got it, and we shall get going with the warm up. Okay, so if you do that march through for me, please. Little march through. Okay, get those arms going across. Already feel that there's a little bit of tension on the abs. Shoulders back and down. Okay, and up with those arms. Okay, step touch for me. Okay, and back. Good, so again, each time my arms are going out, I get a little squeeze on my pecs. My shoulders are back and down, so I can't lean forward, can't get my shoulders forward with it. Okay, with a leg curl, leg curl. Good, so again, using the pecs to get that crossover at the front, then the hamstrings and the glutes to get that kick up at the back. Little stretch out at the front of the leg. Okay, circle the way that I'm going. Then you come up on your toes, reach it up and out for me, give me that lift. Ribcage already down and in, and again. And up. I'm going to kick out with one leg. Little kick out, little turn. Feel those abs already pulled in for you. And feel each time you're pushing down with that flat arm, there's a little bit of a tricep work going on there as well, on that outer arm. Okay, change arms, change legs. Good, so pushing it down. Give that little turn as well. Feel that you're pushing through the air, make it strong. I'm going to go back to my step touch, this time elbows. Now up on your toes, both elbows, going back, give you that squeeze. Good, open out that chest, and again. Good, here. I'm going to come over the top, a little over the top. Lovely, I'm going to come across the front, shoulders back and down, give me that turn. 4, 3, 2, 1, stay here, little runner, on that front leg. Now re-priming those abs, get them pulled in. Good, got another 8. Got another 4. I'm gonna change direction with my runner here. Runner. Good, so give me that squeeze. Driving back with that elbow, driving up with that knee, so we've got that little bit of oblique work going on as well. 4, 3, I'm gonna do an out box here, so I go wide. Go wide, go narrow. Good, so just dropping down. Now I'm going to change over my lead leg. Down, down, up, up. A squat here for me. Squat. Use those hip flexors to get up. Get that knee up. And then sitting right back on your heels. Okay, just getting the arms out. Good. Thumbs leading. Open out that chest, long straight arms. Okay, wide squat here, well done, wide squat. Push it up. Now I'm gonna do a little lean forward. Lean forward from the hips, and coming up, and one more. Back into those squats for me. Down, push it up. Then the lean, abs pulled in, straight back, push up. And well done, okay, lovely, good. Okay, ready for your first set. What I'm going to do first of all is just to grab a set of my 3 kilograms, my lighter weights, and I'm going to be doing a pull back and a kick back on my triceps. Okay, so are we ready to go? You've grabbed your weights. Just going to bring us down. 3, two, straight back, one pull back, one pull back, kick back. Good, so reasonably heavy weight. Remember, I'm leaning forward from my hips, got my abs pulled in, shoulders back and down. Good, so I'm not throwing that tricep lift up. I have to get that pull back, feel that pull back, and then the lift. Good, so go at your own pace. Good, up, pull it back. And well done. Okay, I need one weight for this. It's gonna be a squat and a turn whilst I'm keeping my hips to the front. They don't turn with me. They stay forwards. I have to use my obliques to get that turn. Then the other side. Okay, here we go. Good, so strong on your squat. Then really drive that elbow back. That weight is just keeping my arms in that train track position where they're just parallel to each other, and I'm getting that turn. And turn it back. Lovely, good. Up and turn. My hips are the constant through all of this. Good, my zip and hollow is on. Priming those abs. Give it a squeeze back. Keep heaps and knees to the front. Okay, well done, lovely, good. The lift and the kick back, my second set. Okay, so get ready. My weight's back on my heels, my knees are bent. I'm going forward, I haven't let my shoulders go over. It's rocked and back and down. Okay, I get that lift. I get that lift with that kick out. Pull it up, hold it up for that kick out. Good, lovely. Keep that zip and hollow on. Onto my second circuit now out of four. So remember to pace yourself. Up, kick it back. And well done, good, okay, lovely. Okay, onto my next one. I only need the one weight for it. Hips are constant, tip and hollow on, rib cage down and in, shoulders back and down. Lovely. One squat, do me that turn. Good, so on my squat, I'm back down on my heels, give me that turn. My zip and hollow on, then one arm pushes the other one back with that weight. Again, you can go light on weights, and if you don't want to use a weight, you can just use that hands together at the front and do me that push. Good. Hips constant. Sitting back, give me that squeeze up. Feeling strong at the top. Squeeze. Last few seconds now, we're in singles. Well done, okay, good work. Okay, my lift and kick back. Halfway through that first set. Okay, so I'm here. That lift, push back. Give me that lift, hold that lift to get that kick back. Lovely, good. And then just keep on checking if you can, either with a feel or if you've got a mirror there, just check that your back is flat and that your shoulders are back and down. Just keep on checking on your own position. That is good. Good, so my core is pulled in. And good work, well done. Onto that one weight. Okay, nice and strong on that squat. hips to the front, they stay to the front, zip and hollow is on. Okay, here we go. Give me that turn. Good, squeeze it. Give me that squeeze. Really feel that zip and hollow, keeping your hips to the front. And then a little bit of my lat work, also a little bit of my back obliques, the back of my waist to get that turn. Good, squeeze it. Well done, okay, good. Are we ready for our fourth and final circuit? We've got one aerobic section after this. Okay, length forward, give me that pull up. Give me that pull up, lift up and kick back. Lovely, good. And as I go down, arms are long, but my shoulders are back and down. Single figures now, make each one a good one. Get that lift, get that kick back, so no swinging. Well done. Down to one. I'm gonna keep this one weight for my aerobic one at the end. Okay, so the squat, the turn. Good. That tension on, belly button pulled into spine, my zip and hollow on, hip to hip. Good, give me that squeeze. Lovely, good. Triceps and abs, two very popular exercise areas. Good, lovely. Working those tops of the arms. Well done, okay. On my aerobic one, I'm gonna come down, I'm gonna do a lift, comes under, and then the other time. So again, if you want to, you can do a little hop at the end. Otherwise, it's a knee up, foot goes straight down under. If I go down, here, under, down, here, under. So I'm lifting that leg. Now what I can do here is put a little jump into that. Little jump in. Yeah, so again, as it's coming up, I don't swing it. I get that lift off the other leg. Up, goes underneath you. So you can change legs on each one. Good. Up, we're just doing that 1 minute, or that 45 seconds, should I say. And then we're gonna be moving on into our next circuit. Well done, okay, lovely, good. I'm just gonna need one weight for this. For the moment, I'm just gonna go with my usual weight. I'm gonna go down here into my curtsy, one tricep, come back up. Okay, so here we go. Good, my abs pulled in, get that tricep, drop overhead, lift. And remember, we have to go straight on this. Straight up. Give me that lift. The next one's going to be the other arm all the way through. Good. That straight lift. You can always decide when you're here if you want to go higher with the weight on this arm. But it's important that when I'm here, I get that elbow really straight. And well done, good. Okay, now I am gonna go up. Two weights for my next one. My knees are soft. because this is going to hang. I'm not going to be lifting this, I'm going to be squeezing it on the other side. Okay, so hips to the front, give me that drop, give me that squeeze. So you can see, I'm not going to try and lift this weight through the arm. That weight is just taking me over, and I'm getting a really good squeeze on the other side. Good, so keep that elbow out, knees are soft, really get that squeeze down as much as you can. Just squeeze it. Just squeeze it. Good work, well done. Okay, put it somewhere where you're not going to step on it. I'm going to go up a little bit higher in this other one. I felt I could do a little bit more work. So I'm going to do that curtsy, lift up, slightly heavier weight here. Okay, so down to the curtsy, up, tricep, and then come back up. Here, so I'm working my core as well in this. Good. It's going to go straight over my head. Watch you don't clunk yourself. There. And I know that my hips are to the front, shoulders to the front. Good. Down, lift, drop, and lift. Up. Good. Do me that drop, lift. And well done, good, okay, lovely. With that other weight, it was on this arm, with this the squeeze, this time, other arm, knees are soft, hands behind my head, my elbow's always out, don't let it come across your face. Okay, and give me that squeeze, give me that drop, then all the way over, don't rush it, really feel that you get that squeeze through the side of the waist. Squeeze it down. Knees are just soft. Lovely, good. Really feel you're dropping to one side. Come back and drop to the other side. Lovely, good. Okay, well done. Back to that weight. Remember, I've got slightly heavier, up to you. Curtsy. When you're in the curtsy, the zip and hollow is on, and you can do that tricep drop over your head. Drop, lift. Good. Dropping it down. Think about all those component parts. Zip and hollow on, rib cage down and in, even on the side where I get that lift, because I'm going to stabilize myself each time. Good. Get with that tricep work. Up. Lovely, good. And well done. Okay. I'm glad I went with that heavier weight. Okay. Now my heavy, heavy weight on that first arm, squeezing to the side. Okay, here we go. Do me the drop, do me the squeeze. Good, really feel you get that squeeze down. Feel maybe even your lats underneath your shoulder blade, getting in on that action. Squeeze it down. But here, right across the waist. Squeeze it. Well done. Okay, lovely. Our last set. One on each, and then that aerobic section. Okay, down into my curtsy lunge. That drop, that lift, come back up. Good. Keeping it under control. Good, so remember, we're slightly off balance here. So really keep that zip and hollow on. And get me facing forward to do that tricep drop and lift. Well done. Last time on this arm in this circuit. You're doing great, well done. Should be building that work up. Lovely, drop, lift. And good work, well done. Okay, my last one for my aerobic section. On that second arm, knees are soft, elbows out, drop to that side first, give me that squeeze. Yeah, so those obliques will be well warmed up. Squeeze it for me. Good work. Okay, well done. A little aerobic section. Okay, so I'm going to take a little water break. Out, in quick. Or drop out and drop in. A little bit like we did in the warm up. Okay, here we go. Out, out, in. Good, feel the knees come up a little bit so the feet do come off the floor. Go wide, go narrow. Halfway through, I'm going to say just change leading lengths. That's for both, whether you're doing low impact or high. Really feel that your core is pulled in so you can really get those arms just going across at the front, just slightly across. Good, so again, out and back down. Okay, now change over the legs. I'm just reaching out with the other leg. Good, keep it going for me. We're coming down into single figures now. Good, abs are definitely pulled in. And good work, well done. Okay, now this is where you need a chair to do your tricep dips. But if you haven't got a chair, I'm going to show you the options. So here it is. Here, with your bottom close and lift. Or here, but not back here where you're actually using your legs and not your arms. Then you can be down on the floor if your wrists are okay. You can do that little drop, hands facing forwards, or here and back up each time. If any of those with your wrists do not work, then all you do is you come over to your front and give me that kick back. Then I'm gonna get on the floor and do cycles for my obliques. Okay, are we ready to go? So, either a chair, firm chair that you know is stable enough for you. Okay. Okay, so I'm gonna do those tricep dips. Good. Yeah, I'm definitely going to feel this after four lots of 45 seconds. Good, up. You can start off here and go onto the floor or go back to the tricep kickbacks with a weight or no weight. Remember what we're saying about as long as you make a fist and really drive that back, that will work for you. Good. 15 seconds left now. Last few seconds. Lovely, good. Onto the floor. If you're on the floor already, come back. Elbows out, head up. This is my start position here. Or here, if you don't get the arms all the way up, the legs all the way out. Okay, thumbs onto your cheekbones here. Really open out those arms. Triceps should almost, in this position, get a little bit of a stretch on. Good, so you feel good. Squeeze. Keep the elbows open, keep the head off the floor each time. If you go from one shoulder, with that shoulder coming up, elbow on the end, head relaxed, and well done. Okay, lovely, good. Okay, so stay there to do your dips or your kickbacks, or we're up. We're doing our second set on the chair. Okay, so it's a down and a lift. See what works best for you, because you can bring those legs in a little bit if you want to here. As long as you know you're using your arms to get up, you're not pushing through your legs. It's an easy position just for your body to go, do you know what, it feels better with my legs back here and my thighs are doing the work, rather than here where my triceps are. Okay, lovely, good. Give me that lift. Down into single figures now. Oh, I'm really feeling the second one. I'm not quite sure how the third and the fourth one's gonna go, but I'm gonna give it a go. Lovely, good. Okay, onto the floor, knees up, hands behind my head, thumbs on my under cheekbone there, so now my elbows are out. Good, so if you feel that your zip and hollow is gonna be compromised by putting your leg all the way out and that your lower back is gonna arch off the floor, do not do it there. You can do it closer to you. You will still get that oblique work going on. Good, so up to you. But do challenge yourself all the same. And good work, well done. Okay, we are halfway through. Whew. Those arms are shake off. I can certainly feel it in my triceps. Okay, here we go. All the way up. Lock those elbows. Even if it means for here, you stay for that 1 second and then you do that drop again. That is better than trying to do faster ones and not getting the elbows straight. Up, up, lovely, so I'm pacing myself now, over halfway, can really feel this in the triceps now, up, three, two, one. Good work, well done. Okay, third on my abs, my oblique abs, thumbs, elbows out, head up, stays up. 3, 2, 1, we are on. Good, so again, give me that little kick out. Good, feel the elbow is not coming across your face. Those obliques now as well. And well done. Okay, lovely, good. My fourth and final one with this seat. So whichever dips you've chosen to do, by now, you will have done all that through the triceps.
Good work, well done.
That work certainly builds up. Up. Look, come on, let's do this to the end now.
I know,
I'm feeling your pain here. Get that push up. It's feeling pretty uncomfortable now. Good, let's do that one more. Okay, well done. I'll be glad to see the back of those ones. Okay, last one of my obliques. Elbows out. Okay, one leg up, then the other. Good, give me that squeeze. Remember, keep your legs close if you want to. Good. Let's drive this through to the end now. Up. Make each one a really good one. 3, 2, 1. Okay, well done. Good. Okay, we are up. This can be low or high. One jack, one power jack. Or one half jack, one step out. One half jack, one step out. Otherwise, it's full jacks, power jack. Good. Up. Lovely. Good. Really feel whichever one you're doing. That your abs are really pulled in. Woo, good work, well done. Okay, take a little water break now. Check those arms off a little bit. I'm back to my triceps. Okay, so little sips of water. Oh good, all the way through. Okay, so on this one, while I was coming up at the back with a straight wrist, try not to make it this, whilst the other one is going over my head. Okay, my sip and hollow is definitely on, my hips stay forward, and my wrists, try not to do that work at the end. Lock your wrists and then straighten off your elbow. Okay, so one is behind, one is up. Ribcage down and in, there, and then lift all the way up. So you notice both of my elbows going really straight. I'm just going to kneel down just so you can see the very top of what my hand is doing. And again, I'm not throwing it. I'm not doing any sort of wrist work at the end there. It's a lift. Good. Powered. Lovely, good, okay, well done. I'm gonna stay down here, I'm just coming down onto the floor. Little oblique squeeze, kick out. Always with my hip bone facing towards the floor. Okay, so it's still my obliques, but my core is helping me, and then my glute and hamstring at the end to get that kick. Yes, so still really working those abs. Think belly button, pulled in towards the spine. And then that zip and hollow on, hip to hip. One leg only. I'm just doing the same leg as the arm that went up. just reminds me which one I'm doing next. Lovely, good. Stay square on that knee, don't roll over. There's a lot of work to be done on that up arm because that's the one I lifted first, but also that's the one that I'm supporting with that leg out of the way. Okay, good work, well done. So you can stay kneeling and come back to standing up, whatever you prefer. And this one's gonna come up, inside tricep, the other one, my outside tricep. 3, 2, 1. Okay, get it all the way up. So again, do not lean back, keep on checking your position with your zip and hollow on. Good, give me that lift. Core work, this arm work, really good. Any swimmers out there? Give me that strength, lovely, good. Okay, well done. I'm just turning around so you can see me. It's gonna be the other leg out, and I'm gonna lift it up to get that squeeze over my obliques here. Okay, lovely, good. Sorry, other leg, that's it, squeeze, and squeeze out. Good, so it's the same arm to leg that I was using before. Good, give me that squeeze. Make sure you are square on that other leg, the other knee. Do not roll to the side. The squeeze has to be done by your obliques with that work building up on your supporting arm. Good work, well done. Okay, I'm back to my original up arm. Halfway through this set. Okay, here we go. Good, give me that lift. And remember about that wrist, especially at the back one, I know it will want to flick it up. Try not to do that. Use that inner tricep. Okay, lovely, good. You're coming down into your halfway marker through this circuit. Keep your head upright, looking forwards. Good. And really get that straightened off of that elbow each time. Good, so. There, straighten off, goes behind my head, straightens off each time. And good work, well done. My up arm is now going to be my supporting arm. I'm in my box, abs are definitely pulled in, shoulders back and down. You have a little bit of a bend, softness at the elbows this time. There, squeeze. Good, so softening the knees when we're standing, or softening the elbows slightly when we're down on the floor, does give me a lot better stance. My stability is a lot better. Good, squeeze it back. You can kick back with that heel to feel that that glute and hamstring is working for you. And good work, well done. Okay, my last one. Last one on my arms, last one on my legs, and then that next circuit after the aerobic section. Okay, are we ready to go? Lovely, well done. Good, thinking about how those triceps will look. Yeah, gives lovely definition to the upper arm. Good, give me that lift. Thank you. pushing it up, pushing it down. Straighten off those elbows. Keep the shoulders where they are. Three, two, one. Well done. Same arm to leg, I mean my box. My tip and hollow is on. Elbows very slightly bent. I'm gonna get that leg to squeeze in using my obliques. Okay. Here, my core is really helping me to keep facing towards the floor in all aspects. Shoulders, hips, I haven't rolled over onto that other side. Good, now squeeze it through. And good work, well done. We're up, we're ready to do that aerobic section. Now I'm going to do skipping, I'm turning my rope. Or if you don't want to do the high, it's here. Okay, ready, here we go. Good. Bring those knees up a little bit more. Get those guys doing the skip. Last few seconds now. And good work, well done. Okay, we're coming to the floor. I'm just gonna bring up a heavier set of weights with me on this one. It's gonna be a tricep drop to my forehead whilst I'm lying on the floor. Now what I want you to think about on here as well is that you have got your shoulders back and down and your shoulder blades are in contact with the floor the whole time. Don't lift them up as you lift your arms up. So again, it's a lot of core work doing. Okay, well done. This is our last full set and then we've just got a little kicker at the end. Okay, so here. You can have your feet on the floor if you prefer. What I want you to do is really concentrate on what your arms are doing. I've got that double lift, my elbows are squeezed together, my weights, I'm squeezing them together as well. Good, so up. Weights down and then one leg goes straight. My zip and hollow is definitely on. Don't let your back come off the floor. Squeeze in. Over. This is now locked. My head is up. My hand is behind my head and it's going to come up and over. Give me that squeeze. Now, even though your hips are locked in this position, do keep your zip and hollow on as well. It's a really good practice. And then I'm trying to look over my thigh to look at my foot. Lovely, good. So remember which leg it was? We're going back on our second set. Okay, feet on the floor. If you want, your knees up. make sure that back is on the floor. My elbows squeezing together so my pec work be done as well, and then get that lift. So from my shoulder to my elbow is my constant. It's my forearm that's get lifted with both weights, obviously, by my triceps. Lovely, good. Up. Good, so again, if you're finding that your triceps are really tiring, you can go down a weight, but try and keep the repetitions going. Lovely, good. Okay, one leg down, the other leg over. My zip and hollow on. My head comes up, my long abs, my rectus abs working for me. Hand goes behind my head. I've always got that curl off because I'm taking one shoulder off the floor. And my other shoulder is slightly off the floor on this. And again, really leave that elbow out and feel that you're getting a little stretch down that tricep. And up and over. I'm not rocking on my hips. I'm having to use my obliques, giving me that waist definition through the sides there. Good, give me that squeeze. Good work, well done. Okay, halfway through this last full set. Okay, so I'm here. Shoulders, shoulder blades down against the floor. Okay, elbows squeezing together and we're up. Up. Good, give me that lift. Lift. And well done, good, okay, lovely. My first leg over, so I dropped it. I put my leg over, now I'm coming up. Head off the floor. Squeezing, looking out for that foot if you can. So remember, get up as high as you can to look out over that thigh without moving a thigh. Do not move your thigh. That is constant. Your hips are constant. So your waist really has to work to get up and across. Okay, over halfway now. Last time you're doing those last few seconds now. Last time on this side, this is the other side on the next time round. So put up as much effort as you can. 3, 2, 1, and well done. Okay, bringing those legs in. Okay, my last tricep with these weights. Okay, elbows together and give me that lift. Good, so I'm pushing those elbows together and those weights. So there is work on my triceps as well, on my biceps, not biceps, on my chest as well, my pecs, and then my triceps to get that lift. Yes, we drive it through now. Up. Let's do this last bit together. Here we go. Good. Drive it through. Into single figures. So you can do this now. Up. Up. And good work. Well done. Okay, lovely. Again, whilst you're here, get ready, the zip and the hollow on, head comes up, those long abs, elbow out, and up and over. Go. So again, I'm still trying to get up high. I know it's my last one on this, but let's work it through. We've just got that little kicker at the end, one aerobic, one little kicker, and then all we're doing then is stretching out. Good, give that squeeze all the way across, look for that foot, beyond your thigh. Last few seconds now, this one. And good work, well done. Okay, we're up. Okay, it's going to be the jump across that imaginary line, or again, single ones like that. Okay, here it is, the last little aerobic one. Good, so it almost feels like you're going down there. Mogul field, you have to get up and across, you have to keep lighting your feet. Good. Squeeze down, push off. And this has all helped really use your core as well. Coming up to your last 2 minutes. You've got 15 seconds left on here. This is your last of your aerobic one, so try and stick with it if you can. That's it, through to the end now. Good work, well done. Okay, on my last little kicker, two ways of doing it. Hands underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips, drop down to your elbows and push up. Now to make it a little bit harder, what I do is I put my hands in front of my elbows, so it's a much harder option to do. And then I'm going to come onto my elbows, everyone can do this, onto your toes, and your last one of today is going to be that drop that hip to the floor. Okay, so knees further away, hands in front of you, get ready to go, 3, 2, 1, and push up. Good, so again, want to feel it harder. My bottom is still up, but my hands have gone away. And push. Straightening those elbows each time, like on every other tricep I've done. Good. We've got 15 seconds left now. Let's do it through to the end. Good work, well done, feeling proud. You've managed that all the way through. Lovely, good. Up. Lovely, good, well done. A little shake off for my last one. Okay, so we're ready, we're in that full bridge. Elbows, my arms will still feel this because they are supporting me here. But this is your last 45 seconds. Feel that core work. Feel that oblique as it drops to the floor, then has to get back off. If you feel that you are sliding back, just shuffle your feet back in. This is our last one now. Good, you have done a great session here today. Think about those triceps, those abs. Good, so that repetition, 45 seconds. Makes it quite tough, and then that repetition of four of each makes it very tough, so well done. Feel proud that you finished it, and well done. Okay, just sitting back on your heels, I'm just going to take that timer off for us. Okay, good work, well done. All right, so on my first one, I'm just going to come up to a kneeling position. One arm up, and just the classic tricep pull down. Okay, so just keep that pull. I'm not leaning back, so remember, keep the zip and hollow on. Lovely. I'm going to come down with the shoulder and just bring that across. So again, that shoulder has helped me today. So I'm just getting a stretch out to the back of that shoulder. Yeah, there's pullbacks first of all when I'm standing position. Lovely, good. And then up. Just keeping that stretch out. Feel you're not leaning back. Just bring that arm over your back of your head as much as you can. Really feel that long tricep stretch, top back of arm. Okay, lovely, then it comes across, lock the elbow, drop that shoulder down, just comes right over your body. Okay, lovely, coming down. I'm gonna come down just onto all fours for now, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna reach through with my arm and just do a reach through. I'm just dropping my shoulder to the floor, getting that stretch out. Feel it now going into the spine at the back, top half of your back. Okay, as I come up, I'm going to stay here, but I'm going to just lift a foot up next to my other knee. I'm going to push my weight down over my front of my knee and keep my heel on the floor. Just going to be done a few jumps here today. So again, I'm just going to stretch out that calf, that Achilles there. I'm bringing my weight to the front and pushing forward. Lovely, good. And now I'm going to go bring that leg down, back onto all my fours, and then stretching out with the other arm. I'm really trying to get my shoulder down to the floor. Just really feel you get that upper back stretch. Up, and then it's my other foot in next to my knee. My weight goes over the front, so again it's just sort of comes in underneath your armpit there, pushing that down, keeping your heel on the floor. Okay, just holding that stretch out for you. Lovely, good. Okay, well done. I'm just going to bring the other knee in, or the other foot in, shall I say, and then I'm just there in that bunny hop. I'm going to drop down, rock back onto my heels, and let my head hang. Now I'm just going to hold on to my arms. They're just interlocked with each other there. Okay, then I slowly unroll. I come all the way up to the top, and try and put it back over my head. So again, I've just got that there, and then I'm just going to do a little stretch out of that position. My obliques work for me today. My hips stay where they are, and then pull. So again, you get a little bit of work on that tricep, depending on how tight they are, but also on your obliques going out and across. Okay, let's do that again. Just drop over to one side. Lovely, up, and then dropping over to the other. Lovely, good. I'm gonna get that double hamstring stretch, lower back stretch. So again, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna tip forward from my hips here, just tipping it forward, and then dropping down, and then interlocking the fingers, and push down. Flats of palms are pushing down towards my feet. So again, I've got that stretch over the backs of my legs, and then down. Okay, now bend my knee, knees, and then coming up here, and again, just a little pull over. My rib cage comes away, but my hips stay there. And then a little pull over on the other side. Lovely, good. Then a little pull in. Just a bent arm this time. Little pull in. Okay, lovely, good. I'm just gonna do two swooshes through, so just watch behind you. Feel that those arms just nice and loose. And then another one. And then up to the top here. Big breath in, and then out and down. Okay, very well done today, especially if you managed to do all of those all the way through. It's a hard task session there. I really enjoyed it. I hope you did too, and I hope to see you again next time. Okay, bye-bye for now.